So with respect to the sex differences, what we've shown is that it appears that testosterone is protective in males, and that's probably why they're less susceptible. They do tend to have lower levels, and we've done a trial where we gave to men with MS who had low testosterone levels, and we bumped them into a high normal level, a low normal range to a high normal range with using androgel, and we found that it slowed brain atrophy, it slowed cortical atrophy, and so we want to do a trial. This is one of these things that could be safe and cheap and so forth, that we want to do another trial with men with MS, treat with them with testosterone, and then look more specifically to see, does this help fatigue? It could help fatigue, it could help cognitive function, it could help their motor strength and walking, so we want to do another trial and sort through that. Of course, then the question would be, well, why do men do worse? Well, we don't think it's because of testosterone, because we're pretty sure testosterone is protective. So then you get into sex chromosome effects, and that's XX versus XY gene effects. And so we have a unique model to study sex chromosome effects that are independent of sex hormone effects. Because usually if you have XX, you have estrogen. If you have XY, you have testosterone. So it's hard to study sex chromosome effects alone, because we know the hormones play a role. So we just have a mouse model that is being now used widely through these NIH grants and through other diseases even to study sex chromosome effects. And what we found is that it appears that the XY genotype is worse for neurodegeneration, which makes sense about why males would be worse, particularly when the testosterone is low, because it's protective. See, so now they've got this genetic susceptibility, not to disease, but to do worse on progression. And when they have really high testosterone levels when they're 20 years old, they do okay. But when the testosterone level starts to drop, when they're 40 or so, then you know that can be why the disabilities are particularly bad. Now the flip side of the sex chromosome story is that we found that when we looked at XX versus XY and we looked at the immune phase of the disease, basically this is like susceptibility and relapses, immune activation, there's CD4 T cell responses to be specific. We looked at XX versus XY gene effects and we found that the XX is much worse than the XY. And we did this in both the MS model and the lupus model. Systemic lupus erythematosus, lupus is 9-to-1 female over male. And so the same thing was happening in both, that XX makes a more robust, more disease promoting immune response than XY. And this is probably why females are worse than males for susceptibility to all these autoimmune diseases. So what we're doing now is we're figuring out, well, what is the X gene? We know XX is worse than XY, but what are the genes on X that are making this immune response so much more robust? And if we figure that out, we will block that gene in females, right? So it can lead to new treatments if you understand sex differences.